The front entrance to Cromwell is dominated by the big fruit sculpture, but the outlook to the north towards Lake Dunstan is all about the Wooing Tree Vineyard.
Hi, I'm Mark Price in Cromwell, underneath a tree known to be a suitable location for wedding proposals. Now the tree's owners have a proposal of their own.
The two couples who own the vineyard have applied to the Central Otago District Council for a zone change, so they can sell some parts for residential use, but use 10% for commercial development, preferably tourism related.
I mean, it might not be us that does this, but we're talking about like accommodation, art galleries, cafes, those kind of things. We were quite clear we don't want to create another mall or another part of town. But we think, the way the town's growing and the tourism side of things, Cromwell, I mean, we know from our cellar door how busy and busy we're getting, much more busy we're getting all the time. I mean, Cromwell's a really nicely placed, just outside of Queenstown and Wanaka.
Mr. Farquharson is one of the four owners who bought the rough 26-hectare piece of ground between the town and the lake in 2002. Although the Wooing Tree itself would remain if the land was developed, some grapevines would go.
Yeah, I mean, eventually we probably will have to get rid of some vines. At the moment we've got some spare land over there and we'll start to probably dig into some of our vines, but there's always going to be a vineyard here.
Mr. Farquharson said he and his partners will be applying for a plan change early next year. I'm Mark Price for The South Today.